ReefDVMs coming at you today with kind of a hobby project. You know, you take a few screws, a couple of horseshoes, half dozen hoof nails, and a little bit of paint, and voila, you can make yourself a coat or a hat rack. These things are seen all over stalls. Normally they're kind of chintzy. I marked up some hoof nails here, and I've got myself some shoes from a relative who's a farrier in the family, and I'm just going to take a little bit of a dikes here, and right where I've got that red line, I'm going to cut myself some hoof nails off, so they're a little shorter. Thankfully, he was able to give me some half horseshoe pieces. As you can see, these are just regular horseshoes that have been, you know, cut in half, which is kind of nice. And I'm going to try to show you how I like to build these so that they look a little more cool. I like to kind of put them together like they would on the actual horse, and make them so they look like they've been in place. So I'm going to mount that half horseshoe right in the center with a little bit of welding. I'm going to take those nipped off hoof nails and stick them in, and then I'll even touch those up as a different color. And then I'll screw it to a wall, and you know, they're inset screws, so you won't even notice them. And I'll paint them to match the horseshoe, so hopefully they disappear. I'm going to do four of them. I'm going to do two outside the door here and two on the workbench. Two outside the door will be for coats, and the ones in the workbench will be more for hats. These things really look nice when they're done. I know they look a little chintzy at the beginning, so the first thing I do is I buff them and clean them all up, make sure we're down to bare metal, and then I hit them here with the MIG welder. You know, just, you know, hit them a little bit. You don't need a ton of weld on them. Get it cleaned up, and, you know, then bring them in. And I'm going to use the Loctite go-to glue. It's basically kind of like a super glue. And I'm just going to put a little bit of glue on each of the hoof nails. And remember, I already kind of put these in and marked them at the beginning there, as you saw, and nipped them off at the level that I want. I'm going to glue those things right down in there. And then I'm going to basically take an anvil and the ball peen, and I'm going to set them just like the farriers do. The reason I want them to be set in is I just want that, you know, real traditional hammered look. And then when I get done painting everything, I'll come back and touch those up, particularly a different color. And that way it'll look really nice and cool on the wall. So once I get the glue on those, I'm just going to set them in place. Yeah, this glue dries relatively quickly. I think it's got a set time of, like, you know, 15 minutes. So it holds up, you know, fairly well for me. Again, it's just a kind of a super glue by Loctite. So let's go get the small anvil, set it on top, and then again, just flatten these right down in there. Just like that. That's all you got to do. And we'll do that for both sides, and you can do it up the center too if you want. I'm just actually going to do the sides on these guys. Wipe off a little bit of extra glue, make sure they're seated well, and we're pretty much going to be set to go. The whole process, when I start to finish on these, with the welding and the cutting of the shoe and stuff, oh, probably four shoes, probably takes, you know, maybe 2 hours. I'll use some medium gloss black paint, and I'll just take them out and found a piece of foam, stuck the screws in the foam, and, you know, spray these little devils up. It took a couple coats. I'm not going to bore you with showing you all the coats of paint that got put on them. But I don't want them to rust on the wall. So here they are painted up. We're just going to let them dry now for a bit. And then once they're all dry, I'm going to take the Chevy paint, silver. I just tend to like that. I have some touch-up automotive paint. And I'm just going to touch up those hoof nail tips. And by doing that, it just makes them pop a little bit. It makes them stand out. The next step is just to put them up, and, you know, like on my workbench here, I'm just going to hang one on each side. Again, great for hats and stuff at these lower levels, which is what I wanted. As you can see, they kind of stand out real nice. They're not a pain if you accidentally bump into them. They're well-rounded. They have no sharp edges. It's kind of a nice project to do on the farm, and good way to use old shoes. And in my situation, I didn't really have any old horseshoes laying around, but the family farrier was kind enough to get me some, which is great. I'm going to put a couple next to the door. As you can see, they really screw in easy and well, and they look really decorative, which is what we wanted. So a simple project to do if you have some old horseshoes laying around and you want to do some stylish things with them. Thanks for watching, folks. please subscribe and like our channel.